Board the Vselka, Kola Peninsula, Russia, January 26th, 2005. That's the Indian Republic Day. Anyway, 23:29 hours. Colonel Alexievich's men have taken control of the Vselka in her berth and are attempting to acquire the warheads from several SSN-20 Sturgeon nuclear missiles. The main computers on the bridge of the sub must be accessed to determine whether or not the warheads have been offloaded. Looks like an emergency mission for Sam.
Fisher, Grim's daughter needs you to get inside the communication room. There's a central server inside you'll need to tap into.
Can I ask why?
As long as you don't expect an answer. Nature of the agency. Be good.
Oh man, you just gotta love Lambert's, you know, witness quick-witted responses. Anyway, moving on. I'm just gonna create a savior for good luck. There already seems to be somebody moving about here. Which way am I supposed to go? Probably where the enemies are. That would make sense, actually. There are two doors here. Which door do I take? Okay. Doesn't seem to be anybody walking around here. Oh, this door is closed. I guess that is the only way then. There's somebody walking about inside. Probably not here. Huh, not here. I guess not here. So, wait, this door here is locked. We can't open it, but there's somebody inside. Meaning that maybe they come out during an emergency? Or maybe that is the exfiltration route? This place also looks pretty nice. We descended from there. A comparatively smaller descension boat than Pandora Tomorrow. Let's see here. There seems to be a shadow here. Oh, okay, nice. Actually, no, not nice. I'm in full light. Nobody's looking at me. There's a computer here. Let me just go into this corner here and stay here all silent-like. I wonder where we go from here. Let me just create a safe. I like to keep saving in these games. Sometimes the saves get corrupted and you don't really know where to go. Okay. This guy just exited this place. There didn't really seem to be anything else there, so I'm guessing this is the only way. And I'm going to go forward with that assumption of mine. Wait, does that guy go ahead and unlock one of the doors there? I wonder, maybe that's why he takes so long to get back, you know? He's busy unlocking doors and stuff. He did not notice me again, and well, that's a dead end over there, so I guess there's only one way to go, really. So let me just go ahead and save here, and set back outside. Yeah, this door seems to be open now. So, hey, that was a pretty nice guy. I mean, he came over and he opened this door for us, which we would otherwise have been unable to open. And doors right there on that corner, as it would seem. Let's see the patrol pattern of this guy before we decide to move ahead with, you know, whatever it is that we're doing. He does not see us, so that is good. Let's see here. What if we do it before he gets to that point? Let's see here. Seems to be working thus far. I wonder what happens if we can get inside the bunk before this guy manages to switch the lights on.
Who is that?
Nobody at all. Why is steering so? Steering is a bad thing, don't you know? Okay. Well, I do have a bunk right here, which I can hide behind. So I shall take it. I'll just create, I'll just save in the, what do you call it, Jeopardy save right here, so that, you know, in case anything goes south, I've got somebody to pin it on. I don't really see any way to go from here. Don't tell me that if I fail at this, I'll have to do this entire sequence again. Let's hope he didn't turn on the light while we're at it, right here. He doesn't come all the way here, so that is nice. So we finally got a little bit of breathing room, actually. I guess we are going to have to take this guy out then. Let this guy come out. Sad it had to end this way, but all things must end at some point. That's more like it. Now you won't be getting up to talk to anybody. No issue. Let me try something here. If I switch this light off. Yeah, that makes. I hear somebody else moving about. There's somebody inside there that I don't exactly want to piss off. Hopefully, I'm not doing anything wrong by doing that. The inside is completely lit. There's somebody right at the door. This is a pretty strange spot that we're in, aren't we? Sorry, isn't it? Okay, let's see here. So this one person. Good thing that the thermal camera lets you see through things like metal and stuff. So I guess there's a guy patrolling there who comes to this door right here, and we need to grab this guy and knock him out. This you probably can get away with distracting him, but yeah, it's sort of a trick thing to do. Yep, a knockout it is. Can't help it in these close quarters. Let me just go back here and wait. This seems to be a pretty safe spot. Nobody's coming over to this door here. How did you hear me? Is what I wonder. Is this supposed to be like a firefight sort of thing here? Come on over, son. You and I need to have a chat. Yeah, this is far enough. Actually, do I want him to want to put him here? Nah, I'll just take him back where the others are supposed to be and knock him out here. You know, so that people don't stumble upon him accidentally, so to speak. The body of this guy. On top of you. Together in life, together in death, inseparable by all odds. Well, actually, these guys aren't dead yet, but you get the point. Yet. So, given the glorious amount of lag, I'd just like to... I wonder why my PC is lagging as much as it is. I'll just make a save here. A quick save. And... Whoa, that is a lot of lag right there. And for what, I wonder? There seems to be only one way. One of the things that I will say about this level is that maybe I like its linearity. There are another set of stairs leading upstairs, and... Excuse me, sir? If you could just kindly stop lagging for a moment there. There's a guy dead in there. I can hear some people walking upstairs. I wonder if this is where we have to go. It most probably is, actually. Let's try heading upstairs. and seeing what it's already saw me. Great. We could shoot this light out, can't we?
Look out there.
Come on, whoever you are, get out here. And then we'll talk about who's out there. Did you find anybody? No? You're not gonna come out here? Well, that's sad. I didn't pick you for that type. I wonder where he is right now. I mean, I practically could probably. Yes, you do. Yes, you do. Where is this guy? There's literally nobody here. Is he downstairs? Is he upstairs? Oh, okay, we're at that point. Alright, fine. Okay. So basically all we need to do is just follow this guy around. There wasn't anybody on this floor. There was somebody on the floor above us. The one we just exited from. Yeah, just slow paced walking there. I wonder if that's how the devs decided, you know what, we're gonna balance this game out by doing exactly this. We're gonna make him walk super slow. And this seems to be a safe spot. So yeah, let me just go ahead and... wait. Yeah, he can't see us, so might as well just go ahead and start walking this way. I guess we could walk a little faster. Afford to walk a little faster. Now I would like to wait for him to turn back. Ah, so that's why he walks so slow. Because he's looking down right at us. There's somebody right there who I would rather like to avoid. Give him a chance, thank you. Do I want to save here? Yeah, sure. Let's go ahead and update the save. Because I might be about to try something risky here. Okay, he just walked away without a word. He stands in front of this thing here. And let's see what more scope that. Anyway, I guess we decide to follow him. So I would suppose. It's not like he can see us in here. So I guess let's just confirm that once. Ah, he won't. He won't be able to. And once he leaves, let's just keep on our way. There's again a person here. But he's again in total darkness. So we are in total darkness actually. So that's fine. We can take this section slow. Just as we turn the corner, there might be somebody else. I do not want to grab this character, even though he might have some interesting news for us. So once he leaves, just quietly leave this place and go downstairs, I suppose. Whoa, there. Okay, we can't stay here. We need to keep going forward. Ammo storage. Sad, I can't go in. A med kit. Thank you. Feel like I'm really going to need it. And that dude is coming right over here. Sorry, there I got a little too eager. Is what happened. And here's the thing, we can't exactly follow this guy. So since this guy's already over here, I'm just going to shoot this camera over into this over right here. And let's see how it reacts. So now that he can see the camera. Okay, hopefully he won't see us, and we will be able to make it in time. Thank God.
Still blood frozen on some of the walls.
Okay.
Are you taking the pills?
Okay.
They help me sleep, but they don't stop the nightmares. killed so many, so easily.
Forget about them. They were sailors and soldiers, men who chose to live by the gun.
That is true.
Been surprised to likewise die.
Whoops, too late. So as soon as this guy turns about, we're gonna make a break for it. Yeah, for a moment there I thought maybe, you know what, the game was lagging again, but apparently not. Open the trap drawer. Come on, let's go down now. And see where we're going for a second. Okay, there's a person there. Just a second. Gotta go attend something for a moment. Oh my god. So mouse wheel hasn't been working properly and I can't exactly set the speed to how I want it to be exactly. So as a result, at some points, yeah, so that is a good speed. You may proceed at that cruising speed there. And let's hope we can make it into this corner. We did. So that is nice. And this guy, he has his flashlight off when he enters this area. So we're fine. Let's see, nobody here. Probably nobody up there either. Oh wait, fuck. There are people up there. Let's just hurry up into this corner right here so that we can hide in the shadows. Whew, that was close. I am going nowhere. There are two people, there are literally two dudes just chilling here. How do I get past this section? Oh my god. Oh wait, this can be. Jump up and grab it. I would certainly like to try. These dudes don't really seem to be patrolling, so I guess it is doable. Yeah. Okay, time to try this again. Yeah, as I noted the last time around, it's interesting how this guy can see me and simultaneously at the same time cannot see me. So let me just press the down button this time around. And that'll keep me crouched. Is there anybody here? Sure sounds like it. Where's the sound lagging, I wonder? Mm-hmm. Okay, so this is practically the edge. We need to wait for him to turn about once. And as soon as he has done that, we can start moving. Come on, mouse wheel, don't disappoint me now. Yeah, that's it. So I'm just going to save here. And the last time what I tried was shooting this thing over here. And as soon as he moves to investigate it, we're just going to go over and hopefully he won't be able to see us here. Was it successful? I guess we'll never know. I'm just going to risk something here. I don't hear any of the footsteps, but that doesn't mean that nobody's here. This... is there a door on the left? Probably a door on the left. I'm just going to update my save here since I feel like I haven't saved in a bit of time. Or maybe I have, I don't even remember. The game gets tense every now and then, and yeah. Wow, just look at how pretty this room looks. It looks beautiful, doesn't it? You got that right. So I guess this is the objective then? I suppose. I'll just update the save that I already created to before triggering the objective. And let's see here. What do we have? 3 shockers. I shall equip that. And I'm going to quick save.
Okay, we've got the signal.
Okay, that too.
Can you trace it, Grim?
I might even be able to read it. Looks like a video signal. Yup. There.
Lambert.
Fantastic.
Damn, that looks
fantastic. Sure, time for you to make yourself scarce.
That looks beautiful. Okay, so yeah.
So we are here. Where is this intruder?
Shh. He's got to be close by.
What exactly did you see?
A shadow that didn't have anything casting it. Just keep your eyes open.
Yes, sirree. Okay, so let these two guys pass, and a shadow that didn't have anything casting it is a hell of a way to describe Sam Fisher, sir. I need to know where you get your lines. so that I can describe Sam Fisher better when I do. Anyway, so I'm guessing one of those doors was supposed to be open, but it wasn't. And let's see if it is open this time around. I sure do hope that it is. Oh wait, let me just grab the sticky cam here. For some reason, I had like a lot of trouble getting to do that. Wait, are those the launch controls? Maybe they are, maybe they are, maybe they are. Okay, let's try this. Okay. Yeah, let's save. Oh, yeah, right. And there's a sniper with NVG.
Watch out, Fisher. You've got incoming.
You sound surprised.
It's a good thing they deployed gas. Is that it? Wait. That's pretty good that you have me surrounded, but
requesting backup.
Got it.
I guess I'll just wait here while those guys do their thing. Let's just quickly sneak by. That was simple. Let's hope there aren't any more surprises like that up ahead. Ooh, that was close. Let me just grab some of this. And let's see here. All these guys have night vision gear, which we can't really compete against. So let me see what I can do. Let me just make a save here. The Jeopardy save, as I like to call it. And let me just quick save here as well. Let's see. I could probably shoot them out before they get to me. Really, Sam? Really? Is there anybody else? Nope. Fine then. I guess this is the torpedo shaft then. And this would be it for us. Damn, this was the extraction was a little hectic, not gonna lie. Okay, mission complete. So yeah, it was sort of a different level. I mean, The levels, two levels before this was rather fun, but this level, it was a little off. Maybe it was because my mouse wheel isn't working properly. Maybe that's why it felt that way to me. But yeah, this mission seemed to be a little off at places. Didn't exactly work as it was intended to. And a few places just felt plain lazy. But it was what it was, and it was good enough. Or so, I suppose. Anyway, that brings us to the end of Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, Stealth Action Redefined. I don't know whether I welcomed you guys to this level or not, and if I didn't, greeting fellow Earthlings, welcome to the final episode of Tom Clancy's Splinter Cell, which is now ended. And yeah, the game overall was pretty fun. Not gonna lie about that, but yeah, it was also clunky as hell, and some of the, parts were a little forced. This part was actually, I'm actually surprised by how smart the AI was at this part, because in other times, during escape sequences like this, they can still detect you even though you're in the complete darkness. But here, they were actually pretty smart and didn't detect me unless it was absolutely necessary to do so. And thinking back upon it, maybe, just maybe, I could have used like a smoke grenade in front of the door there while escaping to, you know, keep him from spotting me. But I didn't do that. So as far as things go, that's that. And yeah, thank you for sticking with it for this long, if you have. And thank you for watching this series. Part of the reason I'm doing this is because I want to play games more consistently, and I thought, you know, since I'm doing this, might as well just try giving being a Let's Player a shot here. And yeah, I mean, I'm actually quite glad that I got to cover one of my favorite franchises. Some of the missions in this were just horrible, but I liked playing this game overall. Nonetheless, the stealth aspect is still there. The, you know, coasting aspect is still there. I mean, if you want to, you can practically glitch the entire game and just, you know, like, not have to stealth at all. You can practically ghost through the entire game by glitching, using some mechanics and, you know, game glitches and stuff like that, exploiting game mechanics, basically. But yeah, this game is sort of a mix between a stealth and a shooter, which is a little different from the epitome of the series called Chaos Theory, which I will be covering soon as well. But until that time, this was a pretty great journey. And yeah, so what I'm going to do next is I'm going to break up my PlayStation 2 and connect it to my television, and I'm going to play all the other games, the PlayStation 2 version of Splinter Cell, so that I can also cover nuclear power plants, something that they didn't have in this version of Splinter Cell. So, you know, I'll insert that as video 5.5 or 6.5 or whatever mission that is. So, anyway, I'll see you guys again soon. I'm probably going to be covering Daggerfall next. Let's see how that goes. Or maybe I'll cover something else. I haven't played a proper shooter in a long while. Maybe I'll play Bulletstorm or something along those lines. Maybe Rainbow Six, who knows. Anyway, thank you all for watching. Until next time, take care. Farewell, fellow Earthlings.